Hi, my name is Dominique. I'm a technical trainer with SAS. Today, I'm going to show you how to get started using SAS OnDemand for Academics. SAS OnDemand for Academics is how you can access SAS software for free via the cloud from anywhere in the world. All you need is a SAS profile and an internet connection, and you can get started using SAS Studio to write and submit your SAS programs. You can even upload your own data. Let's get started. I'm at the sign-in page. You can find this link in the description box below. If you don't already have a SAS profile, there's a link where you can create one. All you have to do is follow the simple prompts, and you don't need an EDU email to sign up. So anyone can sign up, anyone who wants to learn SAS. If you need to create a profile, go ahead and do that. Otherwise, simply add your login credentials and sign in. We'll select SAS Studio. SAS Studio is our browser-based interface. It can access SAS software that is running on a local or remote server. With SAS OnDemand for Academics, SAS is running on a remote server. So any files or programs or data that we want to use, we'll have to upload it to this server. And we'll do that underneath this section called Server, Files, and Folders. I'll show you how to upload files in a moment, but first, let's see what's already included. I'm gonna go down to where it says Libraries. Libraries are just direct connections to structured data. The SASHELP library is a library that is accessible in pretty much every installation of SAS. It has some data sets that'll be helpful in your programming journey. For example, let's take this SASHELP.class data set. It's a small, relatively clean data set that I can use to practice my programming on. So let me write some code. I'll write a simple proc print step that references that SASHELP.class data set. I'll submit code here in my editor, and you can see my results. Pretty easy, right? Now, if you're unfamiliar with the SAS code that you've just seen, maybe you should think about checking out some of our free e-learning. I recommend starting with SAS Programming 1. You can find that linked in the description box below. Now, let's see how we can work with our own data. I'm gonna go back to the Server, Files, and Folder section. This is where I'll upload files from my local computer. First, I'll start by creating a folder to put my files in. I'll select Files Home, and I'll click on my new icon where I can create a new folder. I'll just call this My SAS Files and save it. And so I can see this underneath my files. This is where I'm gonna upload any files from my local server to this remote server. I'll right-click on this folder. I'll go down to Upload Files, and I can choose the files from my local machine to upload to this remote machine. So any files that are on my desktop, in my documents, etc. So I'll click on Choose Files. I have a Windows operating system. You might have a different type of operating system, but the benefit of SAS OnDemand for Academics is it's all browser-based. It doesn't matter what operating system you have. So I'll select the files that I want to upload, and that is my program and the data that's referenced in my program as well. So this data is all about this party, this hypothetical party that I'm going to throw. I'll click on Open, and it will give me the ability to upload my files. Pretty quickly, I was able to upload my files. So I'll expand the folder that I created, My SAS Files, and I can see the Party Excel workbook that I uploaded and the Party Contacts.SAS program. Let's open up this program. I can see that this program aims to set up the party library that is a connection to that party.xlsx file. And then with that file, I want to take the invited sheet and the contact sheet and create an inner join using procsql. Again, if any of this code is unfamiliar, be sure to check out our self-paced e-learning linked in the description box below. Let's go ahead and see if this code will run. I'll click on my running person. Uh-oh, seems we have an error. Let's check out what is our error saying. Saying that my data doesn't exist. Well, let's go back to our code. This is all because my file path references a folder that's on my local machine. This Excel workbook that we want to access is the one that we uploaded. So we need to change this file path. So I'm going to just highlight and delete that file path. To get the correct file path, I'll go over here to my server files and folders section. I'll right click on the party.xlsx file and I'll go down to properties. This is the new file path that I should be referencing for this Excel workbook. So I'm just going to highlight and copy. I'll close out, and in my live name statement, I'll replace that previous file path with my new one. Let's check and see if this live name statement actually works. So I'll just highlight this one statement and give it a run. In my log, I see a note that says my library reference was successfully assigned. Let's go check out our libraries. And so now under my libraries, I'll see all those previous libraries, and I'll also see the party library. I can see I have the contacts, contacts many, invited, and seating data sets. So these were all sheets in my Excel workbook. Because I used my live name statement and my XLSX engine, I can now access these as if they were SAS data sets. So I'll use this two-level naming system where I have the library name dot the table name, and my procsql code should run perfectly fine now that I've updated that file path. So let's give this whole program a run. And I have my results. Because I've joined these two data sets, I can see everyone that I invited to this party and their contact information. All of this was stored in my Excel workbook that I uploaded to this server. Be sure to follow these steps if you're interested in practicing your programming skills in a free environment. But if any of this code seemed unfamiliar, be sure to check out our free e-learnings. Like if you found this helpful, comment if you have questions, and be sure to subscribe and turn on notifications so that you'll be notified whenever we drop new tutorials and videos. Until next time, thanks for watching.